Just about a year ago, Framingham decided to change the course of its future.
A slim majority of residents voted to reboot their system of government. After 317 years as a town, it's not that Framingham had grown too big for its own britches, it's just that it had become too darn big. So in 2017, Framingham voted to become a city, giving it advantages it never enjoyed as New England's largest town.
We were a over 200 member town meeting body, and I think it's real difficult to make decisions with 200 people. And I think also it puts us in a place for more resources at the state and federal level, because now we have a seat at the table, having a mayor, a representative to be able to advocate for the community.
You have the bones here, you know, it's like you really do.
It's just beautiful. It really is.
Yvonne M. Spicer is Framingham's first mayor. A longtime educator and corporate executive, what experience she may lack running a diverse city, colleagues say, Spicer will make up in passion, grit, and enthusiasm.
What's it like to be the mayor, the first mayor of the city?
First of all, it's wonderful. It's more than what I anticipated, in a way that everything is a new thing for our community. It's very uncommon to be a transitioning city. So I'm building the ship as I drive it, and that's kind of exciting.
This is my favorite. I love this arcade.
Spicer is determined to deliver on the promise so many other Framingham politicians have made, reinvigorating the city's downtown. But stroll around with her and you can see the seeds are planted. Spicer will walk you through a new coffee roastery and take you for sweet pastries at one of Framingham's colorful Brazilian bakeries.
You've been very passionate about bringing new businesses and new economic opportunities to Framingham. Tell me a little bit about that.
We can have these anchor businesses, such as an incubator or new startup companies, and have them anchored in the downtown. Imagine being able to have people live in the downtown, work in the downtown, and then enjoy all of the things that we have to offer. Why not work and live in the community?
Case in point, hundreds of upscale apartments within walking distance to shops and the commuter train are now in the Framingham pipeline. Condos and businesses occupy the stately old Denison factory. Still, says Spicer, as the downtown gentrifies, the challenge will be to ensure that Framingham remains a gateway of opportunity for its sizable immigrant population.
One of the top concerns is immigration and making sure that people feel safe in this community. And knowing people that have been deported or detained, that's been a difficult place sometimes in Framingham.
Restaurants can be incredible catalysts for downtown revitalizations, and since it opened in 2013, Pho Dakao has done its part, luring destination diners to Framingham from all over. Patrons flock here for the aromatic, authentic Vietnamese cuisine.
The unique thing about Vietnamese food is that it's very fresh. It's very flavorful. We use a lot of vegetable in our cooking, and Vietnamese people like to eat, so there's a lot of spices that's involved, and we try to accommodate a lot of different spices into our cooking.
Many call Vietnamese noodle soup pho, but Dang Pham says it really is pronounced pho. Here they make these steamy bowls of delectable goodness in many varieties, the broths simmering down for hours, infusing them with rich flavors that steam your head open on a chilly day.
We serve with a side plate of bean sprout, basil, fresh limes, and jalapenos. You add those additions to the soup, and then you put a little bit of sriracha on it. Some people like it with a little bit of hoisin sauce to sweeten up the soup, but I think the soup is already good the way it is, so I just add a little bit of hot sauce on it.
Pho Dakao offers a full bar menu of tropical drinks and pages of entrees, some with Thai and Chinese influences. The pad thai with crushed peanuts is a signature dish, and the presentation of the sizzling Mongolian beef is a showstopper.
When I bring it out, it's hot, it's sizzling, it smells great. It goes really well with the white rice.
Thanks to a Framingham grant program, Pho Dakao is about to redo their storefront, adding retractable windows for open-air dining. On Fridays, they have jazz and the joint hums.
I see a lot of business owners improving with the downtown as well. And, you know, we get a lot of local support from people in downtown. So I mean, I just love being here. I just love being a part of the whole renovation of downtown.
And there's a lot going on. After our visit, South Framingham was actually designated an opportunity zone by the state and federal government.
Right, and that creates some incentives for investing, and that's generally a win-win situation. It's good for the area. They get some economic stimulus and economic growth, and it's good for investors because they get tax incentives to develop as well. So generally, those things work out very well. Good for them. It's hard to get that.
All right. Framingham's newest industry is growing hope, that is.
Programs in multiple sclerosis, as well as a large effort in Alzheimer's disease.